2 communities have a 4 years unit in ICT program for faculty of engineering. So my question is this: so how do we know and how do we measure have we disrupted education already? Basically, my question is like, what is the KPI that we have reached the goal of disrupting education? And can you answer me specifically on like different age group of people? Because I think in each different age, education has different purpose for each age group. Thank you.
I think that's a pretty good question. I cannot talk about the different age group, but let me give you about the professional education. I think the goal of the professional education is all for like fulfilling career aspiration. So education has to be able to provide the education to help each professional fulfill their career goal. For example, like I want to move to be like a marketing professional or like be a CMO. How can education help me reach that kind of goal? I think that's the most important thing. And that's what LinkedIn is trying to do. LinkedIn is trying to do like by acquiring data, which is an online platform. So that like each professional, let's say like they want to achieve the career goal, they set up the career goal and LinkedIn help them provide this is what we probably need to achieve. This is like a capability you need to unlock. This is what skill you need to master. So then they provide a career goal and learning goal so that you know, like we can achieve your career goal. And I think that's the most important thing. Professional education is all about fulfilling your career goal. So helping professional achieving career goal is the most important thing and the most important KPI. That's what I think. But I don't know about the other age group, for example, like a preschool, that kind of thing. But I can tell you one thing that the KPI system is broken. I can tell it's definitely broken. You're measuring the wrong thing. You know, like that's why the whole system is like broken. You even measure the professors like in the wrong way. That's what I think. Like you have like so many talent. I see many people graduate from top school. They are very very smart. They are like 10 times smarter than me. But when they come to like some university, not here. Like, you know, they become like a dead wood, you know, because they can't measure by the wrong thing. These guys are like a talent. Some guy basically graduated from like MIT, Stanford, they have been in these crib, you know, like on the Hall of Fame of those university. And then like imagine like you know, Bajula is a good university, provide, you know, like opportunity for everyone. So I think like Bajula is a pretty good university. And I can tell like this is my professor, I'm not like very, you know. But I think like the last going in the right direction. But the thing is that like I would say that like, even the KPI shouldn't be set in stone. A KPI like, similar to startup as well. Like you run education like a startup, so that the KPI has to be changed all the time as well. Because I will tell you, in the future, the world like for professional education is moving toward like a freelance economy. How do you measure a freelance like a career goal? You know, when there's no traditional career path. In the past, you were like, okay, I'm a marketing manager, I'll be a marketing manager. That career ladder concept is being challenged by the change of the structure of the corporation. We have to reinvent bringing KPI all the time. What is relevant and what is matter to the current environment? But I can tell you, like, right now, like, KPI in the education system right now pretty much is broken and we need to rethink. And I think it might be easier in some part, like for example, like professional education, to do it like outside of the traditional system. It might be easier, and that's what I'm trying to do a little bit as well. You know, like for example, like KPI, measuring startup, and measuring by the startup success. How many startup got funding? How many startup can survive after a few years? That's the metrics that I measure based on my education. And again, the KPI must be co-designed by the student and the teacher as well. KPI, content delivery assessment, must be co-designed by everyone participating in the education system. And we need the KPI all the time. And I think about like an education system as like a living organization, a living ecosystem. You know, like every part I'm working at them, you have to involve everyone and then you change. I think it's very difficult for our country to change from I don't know, I speak from the point of view of the outsider, but I think it's very difficult to change from within, but I think it might be easier to change from outside, and that's what probably not measured by the broad thing, you know? Probably like, you probably cut this off, you know, cut this part off in the recommendation. But again, I think at least it's worth it doing everything in the right direction, and I am very happy, especially in terms of innovation, startup, and everything, and also like, and then for my own agenda as well. It's easy, you know, like it could have been changed long ago, you know. But I'll give you some glimpse of hope, you know. Like think of us, you know, like we are product of a broken education system. Like for me, you know, like I'm from Copenhagen, I can tell you like, you know, it's very broken. It's nothing wrong with the teacher or everything, it's just the system. You just don't know when to fix it first. It's just like so broken and interdependent. I came from that education system. And every single time I graduate, I'm a product of a broken education system. But we come this far. Imagine if we change the education system by just 2 or 3%. Imagine that. Our country will move much faster. You know? Even though like we are product of broken education system, we come this far, and some of us like go to the global level, succeed and everything. So if we change it just a little bit and continuously, don't give up hope, change it a little bit. I think like this country will go forward a lot, you know. So that's, I don't know whether it's a glimpse of hope or a hopeless, but think about that. I mean it seriously.
Could we summarize here? Could we summarize your criteria in terms of funding, edtech startup, and could you compare funding for your research?
I think number one is I want you to address. I say the sweet spot for education in Thailand, there are like 2 sweet spots, 1 in preschool student, 1 in preschool education, the second one is professional education. So these 2 are the most ready to be disrupted. Preschool, professional education. 2, you are addressing a pain point that's just solved before. And that pain point must be really, really painful. You know, must be really painful. And the market in that area is big. I think like English education, I think like that's a big, very big, ready to be disrupted. Because right now you go to school, you pay like for some class you pay like almost like 100,000 baht, you know, and you get nothing. You didn't learn that much, you know, maybe 100,000 baht, you know. So English education is one big market, fragmented players. Existing player is not really that good, but it's very expensive, high margin. And then I look at the team that is really passionate about education. You know, like because education is very difficult to solve, it takes some time. It's much more difficult than like doing application startup, that kind of stuff, because it requires some time, they're really understanding from inside out. And in the education system, there are so many moving parts. It's very difficult, it's a whole ecosystem. So that team has to be like some education background, very, very passionate, they never give up, and have some education background. In some other area of startup, I'm raising the startup, they don't have like a technical background in that area. But in education, I think that person has to have like a deep education background as well. That's what I think. So 2 areas. And also look at the big market and team with education background. That's the similar thing. And I want the solution that is not like incremental solution. I want a breakthrough. I want a disruptive solution. Like in the past, there's like 10 startups that pitched me on the idea, creating a marketplace for filter. 20 startups, exact same idea. I think that's very incremental. It's not disruptive. I want more disruptive. Solution that really change people's life. Let me change, provide a much better solution for education in these 2 areas. I don't want any more information. So that's it. Thank you very much. Again, been a pleasure. I've been an honor. And thank you very much for inviting me. And I hope to see some of you either participating in changing education, transforming it. wish some of you will change the world, and hope some of you will be on the cover similar to Samia Khan. This guy is on the fourth or tenth cover. I bet the next Thai person that will make the time 100 or on the cover of fourth fortune will do something about changing education in this country. That's the best way to be, change the world. And if you want to make a legacy, education is key. And again, lastly, education is sexy. Thank you.